I use ChatGPT every day, and I could not produce the amount of content I do, like videos and podcasts, without these prompts that speed up my entire workflow. So I'm going to show you all the ways I use ChatGPT, both in the Mac app and using custom GPTs I've trained, to all the prompts that I have running in Shortcuts that helps me with my podcast, videos, and more. All right, this first one is probably the most important. I have a custom GPT that I call my YouTube sidekick. Now, I've trained it in the back end on my own videos, my own voice, and how I like to formulate titles, descriptions, and tags. And I do this every time I make a video. I transcribe the MP3 audio file, which exports faster than the video. So while the video is still going, I'll take the transcript, which I did with Transcriptionist, drop it into my custom GPT here in the Mac app, and then I have a text expander shortcut for this prompt right here. I ask YouTube to create an optimized video title, two-sentence description, and tags in comma-separated format. I tell it the tags must be less than 500 characters, this way it fits in YouTube's box. And typically I plug other videos at the end of my videos that I want to link in the end card, and I ask ChatGPT to recognize those from the transcript, this way I can quickly reference those videos when I'm ready to make the end card. Now when I run this, it takes just a few seconds, and I'm going to get that title, description, tags, and even my end screen videos, and it's all based on my transcript. Now I will typically massage the title and description for the actual video, but this gives me a huge head start, and the title and thumbnail is really important. So offloading that to ChatGPT really helps a lot. The description is usually pretty good. Again, I'll change that a little bit. Tags, I usually end up just copy and pasting because it's related to the video. I'm not exactly sure how much the tags matter in YouTube anyway, and you'll see the plugged videos at the end. This way I know to link them. And next what I'll do is I'll probably ask for more titles. I'll take the title it gave me, I might give it a little variation on the title, and I'll ask it for 10 more title ideas. And I might go through this process multiple times. I'll see the suggestions ChatGPT is giving me, I might take the best one and then ask it again for titles like this. And because you can now A/B test titles in YouTube with the same thumbnail, I will test three titles pretty much every video now. So I'll take one of the titles I like, maybe this one, I'll copy that title to my clipboard, and then I have a text expander snippet that asks it for 10 more like this, and then uses what's on my clipboard right there in the prompt. It's one of the reasons I still use Text Expander over the text replacements built into Mac and iPhone, because I can do things like automatically put my clipboard in parts of the prompt, and Text Expander is just extremely fast. So I'll ask it for 10 more titles, and until I get one I'm happy with, I might just keep rolling through this process. Now the next prompt I might ask if I'm still trying to design the thumbnail is what are some 2-to-3-word headlines I could place on that thumbnail for this video. Now give me 18 different ideas of text I can put on that thumbnail. Some are actually pretty good, and that's the thing. Just having one or two really good ones of all the things ChatGPT gives me goes a long way. Those are my YouTube prompts, but I also do lots of podcasting, including a daily podcast. And I have another custom GPT that I call Summary Scout. Now, I've trained this GPT to give me summaries in the voice of like a news anchor because I want to use these when I'm recording a daily podcast. Now, I use a lot of different summary style ChatGPT prompts within Shortcuts, and I'll get to that in a second. But if I ever just want to quickly pull an article that I'm looking at on Safari, let's say I'm on a website like this, I'll quickly go into reader mode by clicking and holding on this highlights button in the address bar. I'll just select all and copy, and then here in ChatGPT, I have a text expander snippet. I have it mapped to semicolon SGPT for summarized GPT. It takes all the article text automatically with my prompt at the very top. And the prompt is simply summarize the following article into one paragraph. Now the prompt can be short because this is a custom GPT that already has a lot of context and instructions for how to formulate the summary. And there you go, a one paragraph, pretty big paragraph, but summary, which would be great to read in like a daily podcast style format. So whenever I'm not pulling these summaries through a shortcut, I'll do it here with my custom GPT. Now I won't go into super detail with this next one, but I do have a GPT custom trained for Shortcuts. I've been building more and more shortcuts via API, like the movie database, the open food facts, and I don't know how to use APIs or speak JSON, but ChatGPT is actually pretty good at it. So every time I come across a new API, I'll go here to chat.com on the web. I wish you could edit the custom GPT through the Mac app, but I go here to the web and then I'll go to edit that GPT. Then here, I'll give it a link to the documentation for a new API. For instance, I want to build a shortcut that's a barcode scanner for checking prices. So I'll give the link to the API documentation to my custom GPT. I'll tell it just to learn everything about this barcode scanning API. And that's it. I'll click update on this custom GPT. Now it's trained on that documentation, and I can go back and ask it whatever I want when I'm building a shortcut. So as an example, I know it's trained on the movie database API, so I can ask it, help me build a shortcut that pulls new movie release dates in theaters for the next 2 weeks using movie database API. And then it gives me the step-by-step of how to build this in Shortcuts. like getting the current date, adjusting the date, how to use the dictionary. There's the get contents URL, which is the main action for accessing APIs and shortcuts, and then how to pull the dictionary values and the results. This custom GPT has allowed me to build dozens of shortcuts I could not do on my own. And side note, you can get access to my custom GPT and use it yourself by supporting my shortcuts community at shortcut.bot. Over 2,600 people have joined for free, and over 800 have paid to support the community. Thank you for all of those who do that. And when you pay to support, you get access to my weekly live streams where I live stream shortcuts, plus the recording is available after the fact, and I link new shortcuts every week available to download. You also get priority shortcuts requests and my shortcuts GPT you can actually access and use yourself when you support the community. So again, you could do that at shortcut.bot. And also, I now have shortcuts merch, link in the video description. But I'll also use the custom shortcuts GPT to help me with match text commands, which I'm not super familiar with Regex. I was messing around with podcast transcripts and summaries again, so I had to ask it, what is the match text string I can use in shortcuts to pull the enclosure URL for an MP3 file? And when it comes to Regex and the match text or match group commands, this custom GPT has done really well for that. I can just copy this Regex, put this in a match text action in shortcuts, and 90-something% of the time, it works great. For instance, I've been tweaking this shortcut right here, and I use the match text command that ChatGPT gave me here to match the first item in the RSS feed, and then also to pull the enclosure URL. And now when I run this shortcut, I can choose one of my favorite shows. I put the RSS feeds in this shortcut so it can get the latest episode. It matches the first item, that's the first match text command. Then it matches the enclosure, downloads that, and shortcuts here on the Mac is going to transcribe that entire podcast. Then it's going to summarize it using ChatGPT through the Apple Use Models action. You see that prompt right here, create a 3-sentence summary of this podcast plus 7 to 10 bullet points with key ideas. It's all going to do that here in the shortcut and then create an Apple note. And after a couple of minutes, here's the Apple note. Summary, key ideas. You see it has the title of the episode as the title of the note, has the podcast and publish date that it pulled from, and the entire transcription of the show right here. Link to download that shortcut is in the description. Just be sure to change whatever show names you have up here, and you have to put the show's RSS feed in these menu options. So replace these feeds with the feeds that you want. So that's a lot of what I do in the ChatGPT Mac app. But now let's move over to shortcuts because I have a ton of prompts in here. Now, if you watch any of my latest shortcuts videos, I'm using prompts in all kinds of ways. Like here's my food tracker app. This is a pretty lengthy prompt here. Most of these Apple Intelligence shortcuts will have pretty lengthy prompts, like this one for my save for later shortcut, which identifies what the content is and actually tags notes accordingly. But I'm gonna show you the prompts that I actually use on a daily basis. And this first one is called PTS Daily News. This is for a primary tech show. That's my tech podcast with Jason Aten. You can subscribe above. But for paying members, they get a daily show where I narrate the top 5 news stories every day in just a few minutes. Well, this shortcut is pretty lengthy, but it's pulling from lots of news sources, the Apple Newsroom, Tech Meme, The Verge, 9to5Mac, and others. It's getting the latest items from all those feeds. What I do is actually curate what stories should be included in that day's daily podcast. And then you see I have a prompt right here. Summarize the following article into one paragraph, cut any fluff, and be sure to mention specific names of people, devices, or software. It's a simple prompt, and underneath that will be the full body text of the article that I chose. It sends that to ChatGPT using the Use Models action. Again, I find this to be much more reliable than the ChatGPT app's own action. And you can find this in the Apple Intelligence section, Use Model action right here. And then lower in that shortcut, I also say, based on these articles, write a podcast title that focuses on the 3 main topics, very cut and dry, no superlative language or adjective-laden wording. Also write a podcast description for this episode, same style, only 2 to 3 sentences long. So that's the whole prompt, and then underneath that prompt, I'm actually pulling all the headlines of the articles that I chose for that day. And then in the end, it creates a bare note with all that information, the title, episode description, formatted links, and then summaries for the 5 articles that I chose. I'll show you how it works. When I run this shortcut, I'm gonna say I wanna get new links. This is showing me Tech Meme, and I can choose articles from here. Or if I don't want any, I can click done. This is gonna show me The Verge. I'll choose this CNN app story. I can choose some articles from 9to5Mac, and it's only filtering articles with today's date. So this is not looking into past days. This way I can be sure it's the latest news. This is another news source. I can choose a couple, click done. Now it's created a bare note with the links that I chose right here up the top. And after a few seconds, here it's appended to my bare note, the podcast episode title, the description. Here's all the links formatted so I can just copy this whole thing, paste it in my podcast host and an Apple Podcast Connect, and then I have the summary of each story underneath. I'll go in and massage this a little bit, maybe add my own thoughts and voice to it, but this is basically an hour or multiple hours worth of work in a shortcut and preparing this note for me, and I can run that in the background while I do other things. All right, and one final shortcut and some GPT prompts. I have here my Primary Tech Show notes shortcut, and I run this once we're done recording an episode of Primary Technology because I want to be able to format the show notes very quickly. I don't want to spend any time with it. So what I do here is in Safari, I create a tab group for every episode. So here's episode 103, that was our latest one. Every article and website we talked about, it's here in the tab group. Now while we record, I'll share my screen, this way we have a visual, but once I'm ready to format the show notes, I'll go here to the tab group in Safari, click the three dots, and then I can choose copy links. That copies all the URLs for every page in this tab group to my clipboard. When I click copy links, I can then minimize this. I'll go to my shortcut, and I actually run this from the menu bar. This is a nice macOS Tahoe feature where you can add shortcuts right to the menu bar, customize which ones appear. So I'll just click this PTS note shortcut right here and then start doing other things like editing the show. But I'll run it right here so you can see it in action. And what this is doing is getting every article from that tab group, formatting that for show notes, both HTML style and in rich text, so I can copy and paste it into a YouTube description. But it's also going to tell me to choose what articles I want to highlight for the title and description of the podcast episode. So this menu just popped up and say, yeah, I want to talk about iOS 26.2. I want to talk about timed links in Apple Podcasts. And let's talk about Perplexity and Amazon. Now I just check those three headlines. And when I click done, it's going to send those three headlines to ChatGPT through my prompt about creating an SEO-optimized podcast title and description. And then just like that, it created a bare note. This is Primary Tech Show, automatically adds today's date. Here's the title for the podcast episode. Again, I'll always massage that and change it. I never take it straight from ChatGPT, but it's a great head start. In the same way, this is the description that it pulled from those three articles I chose. And then underneath, our entire show notes are already formatted. Here it is in HTML, all the links nicely formatted for the show notes. And then I also have them formatted here so I can copy and paste them to the YouTube video description. And YouTube wants just plain text and full HTML URLs. And so I do all of that here. And that quickly, I have my show notes done for the podcast and I can focus on editing and adding chapters with chapter artwork. Come back to this note when I'm ready to publish, massage the title and description, and I'm good to go. So those are the prompts that help me get things done every day for my videos and podcasts and more. If you have any questions, leave comments below this video. If you want me to link a shortcut or prompt that I didn't put in the description yet, let me know in the comments. And I would appreciate if you join the Shortcuts community, shortcut.bot. There you can support the channel and me as a creator and tune into my weekly live streams where I get to build shortcuts live and take your requests live, like webinar style. It's pretty fun. I put my last Apple Intelligence shortcuts video right here. And get subscribed and hit that like button because another roundup of Apple Intelligence shortcuts coming very soon. And I'll put another video right up here that YouTube thinks you'll really enjoy. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.